साद्वैतं सावधूतं पर्यन सहितं श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान् सहगणललता श्रीशाखान्विताश्च आजानलम्बितभुजौ कनकावदातौ सङ्कीर्तनैकपितरौ कमलायताक्षौ विश्वम्भरौ द्विजवरौ युगधर्मपालौ वन्दे जगत्प्रियकरौ करुणावतारौ नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमम् देवी सरस्वती व्यास तत् जयबुदीर वाछाकृभ्य कृपा सिद्धुभ्य पत्ता पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। हे श्री सनातन प्रभु करुणाबुराशे हे ऊ दुर्गत जनक दयावलोक हे भक्ति सुमते रघुनाथदास श्रीजीव मे कुमते दयांतरा। बोलो वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय। परम मंगल श्रीमद्भागवत महापुराण एकादश स्कंद पांचवा अध्याय ग्यारहवा श्लोक। ग्यारहवा श्लोक श्री वेरी वेरी ऑस्पिशियस श्री श्रीमद्भागवत महापुराण एंड in the dialogue conversation between Shri Nimi Maharaj and Nav Yogeshwar. Shri Nav Yogeshwar was describing the Bhagavata Dharma, that means Sadhan Bhakti Marga, and in Sadhan Bhakti Marga Shri Nav Yogeshwar name is Trum in Chamas Yogeshwar was describing that Shastra has described and glorified Karma Marga, but that Karma Marga is not to make persons involved in karma, but that is only to make them get rid from karma marga. That means to leave karma. The glories of karma was described, because while they are describing the glories of karma, at last in conclusion Shastra will say that by doing this karma, At last, in conclusion, a person will get calamities and at last he will get into the sinful places. That means narak, hell. So, actually he is saying, the karma, Shastra is saying that one should not have very much faith in karma. He should do karma only to make his heart full of sattvagun. That means for cleaning his heart, the karma is prescribed. Otherwise, karma is not the goal. Karma is only to wash one's dirt from his heart so that he can be saved from sinful activities. So he is, Shri Chamas Yogeshwar is saying, as a mother is having laddu in his left hand and in the right hand he is having the medicine and he wants to feed that medicine to a child, his child, and she is saying that if you will drink this medicine then I will give you this laddu. Actually saying, mother is never intended to give laddu to that boy, because by eating laddu his stomach, his digestion will be ruined. Actually she want to give the medicine. In the same way, Shastra want to make us free from karma marg. But they are in the beginning, preliminary, they are saying that karma is so great, karma is so great, you will get swarg, you will get so many belts, you will get so many facilities of having, enjoying the senses. So they are saying in this way, but actually they want to make a person, they want to suggest a person ashtism, vairagya, and by preaching the mortification vairagya, they are only, they want to preach vairagya, but they are previously, they are saying that karma is so glorified, karma is so full of glories. So jayanti asishtang vidhan dakshinai vrte param ghant pashun tad vidha. But some foolish persons are not realizing the motive of Shastra. While he is Shastra is describing the glories of karma, the person are not realizing the motive of Shastra. And in 11th verse he is saying ke loke vevaya mishmadya seva nityastra janto nahi tatra chodana. A man is naturally attracted to sex. Man is naturally attracted to the taste of his tongue. So Shastra will not ever order, or Shastra will not do the natural thing. He will not order for natural thing. As Shastra is not saying that you take breath, but we have normally everyone of us is taking breath, swas. But so Shastra will not say Shastra will not say ki, that you should sleep for 6 hours or 5 hours, because this is natural. So whatever is natural, that is not prescribed, that is not suggested by Shastra. Shastra always suggests, the vidhi always begins, which is not prapt. Aprapte praptakarini vidhi. The definition of a vidhi, definition of a rule is this, that which thing is not normally achieved, Shastra want to achieve it. So aprapte, the thing that is not already achieved by us, praptakarini, Shastra want to allow us to take that. So we are eating, we are sleeping, we are moving, we are taking breath. So Shastra will not order for that. Shastra will order that you should control your breath, you should do pranayama. So that is which thing is not found, which thing is not available, Shastra will order for that thing, not to that thing that is easily and naturally achieved by us. So aprapt, which is aprapt, there how it can be achieved, there is vidhi. Or which is prapt, how we shall stop it. Vidhi is for that, not to the easily prapt thing. So he is saying that vyavai, that means sex, in the same way the taste of tongue, spicy things we are taking, eating those things, Shastra will not order for that. Shastra will order that no, you should not take such a spicy food, but you should take a very simple food. So which is not achieved, which is not available, Shastra will always say for that. So that is the Shastra. So loke vyavaya, in 11th verse he is saying, Sri Chamasi Yogeshwari is suggesting ki loke vyavaya, in world the sex, use of sex, amish, that means the eating of non-vegetarians, non-vegetarian food, meat, amish means meat, and madhya seva, madhya means the use of consumption of liquor. So a normal person is itself normally it is attracted to these things. He want to take better taste, he want to take liquor, he want to take sex. So Shastra is not doing, not allowing or not suggesting it to be involved in those things, but he will, Shastra will always protect us, Shastra will always deny us that you should not take these things. To loke vyavaya amish madhya seva nityastu, they are naturally used every day. Nityastu janto nahi tatra chodna. Chodna means the Shastra is not motivating us. Nodana means motivating. Shastra is not motivating us for that. Vyavasthit steshu. But if a person cannot live and he is very much keen to have sex, to have take the delicious foods and to use sometimes wine or liquor, then Shastra is making it limited by doing that vivaha yagya suran suragrahi asu, that if you cannot leave sex and you cannot have the brahmachari austerity, then you should permitted to do sex only according to the merits. Unless you are married, you will not have that sex. So to make it make this instinct limited, Shastras always allow us to doing that. तो लोके व्यवहार, सो व्यवस्थिति तेषु, व्यवस्थिति मीन्स शास्त्र इज मेकिंग इट लिमिटेड बाय विवाह, दैट इफ यू कैन नॉट फॉलो द ऑस्टरिटी द होल लाइफ, देन आफ्टर हैविंग मैरिड ए मैरिड पर्सन, शास्त्र अनुमोदित ही शुड डू द he should he is allowed to do sex, otherwise not. So vivaha, by vivaha sex is limited, and by yagya, if you want to take non vegetarian, then in satyog by slaughtering and by offering a goat or a animal to the dev, that can be used, but in Kaliyug it is also not allowed. There only the cattle will be touched, it will not be slaughtered, it will only touched. So vivaha yagya, in yagya the violence is allowed, that means slaughtering of a cattle is allowed. And suragrahi, in the same way, if you are not in this position that you leave the liquor for whole life, then to make it very much limited, and as a exceptional case, the madara or sura, the wine, can be consumed only in yagya, in while in yagya there is a ritual where somras can be drink, some wine can be drinks. So that was also in satyog. In Kaliyuga it is also denied. He will only sniff the somras. He will not drink it. In this way, as nivritti ishta, these are exceptional case and they are not the permission, they are not the motivation to take them, but it is to make it limited, that in a circular position, circular circumstances, these things can be achieved, these are permitted. So in this way Shastra is always protecting us for the natural downward going path. Shastra is always suggesting us for that. So dhanam chaka dharmaika phalam yato vai, Shastra is saying that if a person has wealth, then dharmaika phalam, its result should be practicing dharma, religion. If a person has wealth, then he should use it. He should spend that money for dharma.
तो धर्म च धर्म एक फलम यतो वही ज्ञानम एंड इफ ही विल डू धर्म रिचुअल्स बाय रिचुअल्स ही विल गेट ज्ञान. तो द रिजल्ट ऑफ धन इज गेटिंग धर्म एंड द रिजल्ट ऑफ धर्म इज गेटिंग ज्ञान एंड द रिजल्ट ऑफ ज्ञान इज गेटिंग सविज्ञान. दैट मीन्स द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ ज्ञान. द नोइंग अबाउट एनीथिंग इज ज्ञान एंड एक्सपीरियंसिंग इज इट इन हिज ओन ओन लाइफ दैट इज कॉल्ड विज्ञान. तो ज्ञानम सविज्ञानम. अनुप्रशांति एंड एज सून एज ए पर्सन विल गेट विज्ञान माने एक्सपीरियंस देन ही विल गेट प्रशांति ही विल गेट ट्रांसक्वेलिटी. अदरवाइज ट्रांसक्वेलिटी कैन नॉट बी अचीव बाय दैट पर्सन. बाय ज्ञान द ट्रांसक्वेलिटी विल कम. ग्रहेषु इंडी कलेवरस्य मृत्युं न पश्यन्ति दुरंत वीर्यम. द पर्सन्स हु आर लिविंग इन हाउस लिविंग इन होम दे आर ग्रहेषु इंजन्ति दे आर इन्वॉल्व इन मेटीरियल एक्टिविटीज एंड दे कलेवरस्य मृत्युं न पश्यन्ति. दे आर नॉट वेरी मच दे आर नॉट नोटिसिंग दैट हिज बॉडी विल डाई वन डे. तो कलेवरस्य मृत्युं न पश्यन्ति दे विल नॉट नोटिस द डेथ बिकॉज दे आर एंजॉइंग दे आर फैमिली लाइफ ओनली. एंड मृत्यु इज तुरंत वीर्यम. मृत्यु इज सच ए थिंग विच कैन नॉट बी कंकर्ड बाई एनीथिंग एनी वन. सो इट इज अनकंकरेबल एंड दे आर नॉट नोइंग मृत्यु. सो एक्चुअली शास्त्र हैज द रिचुअल्स बट दोज रिचुअल्स आर नॉट टू ग्रेटिफाई वन्स सेंसेस वन्स डिजायर्स बट इट टू लीव दोज बैड डिजायर्स एज नाउ ही इज डिस्क्राइबिंग द प्रीवियसली ही वॉज रिफ्यूजिंग देन वॉट शुड बी डन द परमिसिबल थिंग ही इज नाउ डिस्क्राइबिंग यद यद घ्राण बक्षो वेद स्वराया. ए पर्सन शुड ओनली घ्राण भक्ष दैट मीन्स ही शुड ओनली स्निफ द सोमरस द लिक्विड ही शुड नॉट ड्रिंक इट. यद घ्राण भक्ष घ्राण मीन्स बाय हिज नोज ही शुड ईट दैट थिंग ही शुड टेक ही शुड कंज्यूम दैट लिक्विड. यद घ्राण भक्ष बेता स्वराया स्वराया मीन्स लिक्विड. द लिक्विड कैन बी कंज्यूम्ड ओनली बाय स्निफिंग इट घ्राण भक्ष. तथा पशु आलोहनम न हिंसा. इन द सेम वे वे आर द रिचुअल रिचुअल ऑफ स्लॉटरिंग ए कैटल इज डिस्क्राइब्ड. एक्चुअली दैट इज नॉट द स्लॉटरिंग बट पशु आलोहनम ही शुड ओनली टच एंड मेक दैट कैटल फ्री एंड ही विल नॉट यूज ही विल नॉट बाइंड इट in his possession he will leave it that according to his own will let that cattle be roam anywhere. So yat pasho alavam alavam means only touching and making him go according to his will let him roam according to his desire. तो यद पशु आलोहनम न हिंसा. एक्चुअली द वायलेंस इज नॉट परमिसिबल दैट इज नॉट सब्सक्राइब्ड प्रस्क्राइब्ड एवं व्यवहार Prajya Naratya. In the same way, the sex is permitted only to increase the generation, not for one's own joy. So here Vyavaya, that Vyavaya means sex, that is Prajya, to increase the generation. Nahatya, not for one's satisfaction or one's joy. Imam Vishuddham na vidu swadharmam. The foolish persons are not realizing this swadharma, this religion. The main swadharma is, the original dharma is to serve Shri Krishna. Because Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Shudra, they are manifested. Brahman was manifested by mouth, Kshatri was from his hand, Vaishya from his thighs, and Shudra from his legs, feet. So, by our feet, by our thigh, by our hand, by our mouth, we should serve Shri Krishna. The serving of Shri Krishna is by mouth to chant his name. The serving of Shri Krishna by our hands, that is to serve Shri Krishna. By thighs, we will always be alert to serve Shri Krishna. And by foot, we will do parikrama of Shri Krishna. In this way, from the limbs, we are, the burn are manifested. The burn has all chaturvarn, chatur ashram, burn and ashram. They are meant to do service of Shri Krishna. That is the main thing. So, Vishuddham na vidu swadharmam. The persons are not knowing their swadharma, nishdharma, and they are using it, that, and they are having this, pretending it, that, oh, Shastra has given us permission to do sex, to do consume liquor, to kill a cattle and to take meat, but that is not the permission of Shastra. Shastra is only minimizing our and limiting, making limited our desires. He is not, it is not permissioning at us to do that. Yet, tvevam vido sant stabda sadavimanna pashun drahant vishabdha prithi khadant techitang. But yetu evam Vido asantaha, asantaha, that means those wicked persons, those bad persons, who are not good. Asant, sant means good, asant means bad, the bad persons. Yetu a evan vidaha, who are not realizing, not understanding the sense of Shastra. Evam Abhidha, who are not taking the gist or the purport of that Shastra, the gist of Shastra, who are not understanding it. And Stabdha, they are so arrogant, Stabdha, arrogant, Abhimani. And Sat Abhimaninaha, they have the proud that we are doing dharma. We are doing the rituals and we are following the Shastra. Sat Abhimanna. In this way, those foolish persons are Pashun Druyanti. They have the enmity with those Pashu, those innocent cattle. So Pashun Druyanti. They are having enmity with those innocent cattle and Vishraddha and being fearless, Vishraddha, fearless, they prete khadante techitam, they kill them, then the result will be prete. While such a person will die himself, then te khadante techitam, those cattle will also eat him. As he has eaten those cattle, those cattle will also take revenge and they will also eat him. Manso, the meaning of mans is in this word itself. Mamso, mamane to me, samane, he will also eat me. As I have eaten him or it, in the same way, it will also eat me. That is the mansa, mam or so. Mam is to me, samane, he also. That is the meaning of mansa. So that is the worldly meaning of mansa. Mamsa. So he is describing this, ki pashun druhyant vishraddha, being very much arrogant, they are killing cattle, animals, prete khadanti te chitan, while such a person will die and he will go to hell, then those persons will also take revenge and they will eat his flesh. Dushyant parakayeshu swatmanam harmishwaram mrtike sambandhesmin bhatasneha patantyadha. Dushyant parakayeshu, a person who has the enmity with other person, Dushyant parakayeshu, and who is killing the other person, swatmanam harmishwaram mrtike sanubandhecha. So sanubandhe mrtike mane dehe, while his dehe will be finished, then asmin baddhasneha, they have the relationship with their son and their own santan, but they are having enmity with the other animals. Then at one place he is having love and on other place he is became very much cruel. So this is very much strange. A person is loving his son and being cruel to the cattle, being cruel to the animals, and he is slaughtering and killing those cattle or those animals. Then it is very much astonishing. It is very much strange. So Dushyant parakayeshu swatmanam harmishwaram, actually he is having the enmity with Shri Krishna, because Shri Krishna is always all pervading, and Shri Krishna is also resting in the heart of every person, everything, every animal, every living entity, Shri Krishna is there. And if a person is killing to a animal or to other living entity, then actually he is hurting Shri Krishna. So Dushyantaha, he is hurting Shri Krishna. Parakayeshu swatmanam harmishram, because Shri Krishna is also resting in the heart of every creature, every living entity. But mritike samvandhesmin bhatasneha, that person is not realizing it. He is only loving to his own body. Or samvandhe, the persons that are relating to his body. So mritike and samvandhe, mritike means to his body and samvandhe means related to that body, who are belonging. So he is only loving his body and belonging to his body and belongings. Then asmin baddhasneha, he is tied with the love to his body and belongings. Then patantyadha, he will fall down and down. Patantyadha. Ye kaivalyam asamprapta, ye chati tashti murutam, taivarvika yakshanaka atmanam ghatiyantite. Ye kaivalyam asamprapta, the person who has not achieved the thought that I am not the body. Kaivalyam asamprapta, body is an other thing and my soul is an other thing, who is not realizing this thing, and who is realizing, who is just confused that body is atma, body is the soul. So if a person is confused that body is the soul and he is not taivarnika yakshanika, this varna vyavastha is also not everlasting, eternal, and it will also ruined, because a person has left this body of Brahman and he can take birth in the other body. So where he will go, his body will be destroyed. So the varna vyavastha is kshanik, varna vyavastha is momental, that is not this body as the instrument to serve Shri Krishna. And if we are not utilizing this facility, then we are atmaghati, we are killing ourselves, we are suicidal, we are doing suicide. So that is the atmaghati, we are doing suicide. The body, this body is given to serve Shri Krishna, and if we are not serving Shri Krishna, then we are doing the suicidal work. Tai varnaka yakshanaka atmanam ghatiyantite, they are doing suicide. Atmanam ghatiyantite. Ete atmahano ashanta. So these all persons are, who are not serving Shri Krishna, they are actually, they are atmahana, they are doing suicide. Okay? Atmahana, they are atmahanta, they are killing themselves. Ashanta, they are always having disturbed, they will not get tranquility in any way. Ajnane jnanmanina, and they are so confused that they are thinking the confusion to be the knowledge. Ajnane jnanmanina, ajnane jnanmanina, they are confused, but they are thinking that we are very much intelligent persons. Sidanti akrita pratyavai, and they are not getting their goal. Akritkritya means they are not getting their goal. Without achieving the goal, काल ध्वस्त मनोरथ था, दे डिजायर्स मेनी थिंग्स, दे इमेजेस एंड मेनी थिंग, बट द टाइम केम्स एंड टाइम डिस्ट्रॉयज एवरीथिंग. काल रूंस एवरीथिंग, काल टाइम डिस्ट्रॉयज एवरीथिंग. सो काल ध्वस्त मनोरथ था, बाई काल, बाई टाइम, बाई डेथ, एवरी मनोरथ, एवरी डिजायर इज रूंड, इज फिनिश्ड. तो सीदंती दे गेट कष्ट, डिफिकल्टीज एंड अकृतकृत्या, दे आर नॉट अचीविंग देयर गोल एंड काल ध्वस्ता मनोरथा. बाई डेथ देयर होल desires and imaginations are rude, disturbed, destructed. Hitvatya yas rachita grahatya srutriya tamo vishanti anichanto vasudev paramukha. If a person is vasudev paramukha, that means he is left, he has left Shri Vasudev and he has turn his face from Shri Krishna to the worldly material things. So if he is Vasudev Paramukha, he has turned his face, his sight from Vasudev to the worldly things, then they hitva ati ayasa rachita, he has made his home very by very difficulty, just collecting his children and through his friends and his Shri, his prosperity, his death, he has collected this thing with so efforts, so hard, doing hard efforts, he has collected them. But tamo vishanti anichantaha, within no time, the death destroys everything and he has to enter into the hell. Tamo vishanti anichanta, though he is not, he never want to go to hell, even then he has to go to hell, because Vasudev Paramukha, he has left Shri Vasudev, the bhakti of Vasudev. So in this day, the karma marga, the question was, please tell the karma marga, and Shri Chamasa Yogeshwari is describing that the karma should be always related to Shri Krishna devotion, Krishna bhakti. If our activities are not concerned or related to Shri Krishna Bhakti, then those karma will lead us into the hell. Now, Shri Nimi Maharaj, at last he put the question that Kasmin Kale Sa Bhagavan Kim Varna Ki Drisho Nirbhi, ki in which युग भगवान टेक विच अवतार, विच इनकार्नेशन. सो दैट मीन्स प्लीज डिस्क्राइब द योगावतार टू मी, आई वॉन्ट टू नो दैट इन विच युग भगवान टुक, भगवान टेक विच अवतार, भगवान टेक्स विच अवतार. सो कस्मिन काले स भगवान किम वर्ण, व्हाट इज हिज कम्प्लेक्शन, कीदृशः, व्हाट इज हिज क्वालिटीज एंड ग्लोरीज, एंड निर्भी नामना केन, एंड पर्सन एड्रेसेस हिम, द पर्सन एड्रेसिंग इन बाई विच नेम, व्हाट इज हिज नेम. सो किम नामना और केन विधना, एंड बाई विच मेथड श्री दे वर्शिप श्री कृष्ण in various yuga. So in which yuga, what is the name, how Shri Krishna is worshipped, by which method Shri Krishna is worshipped, what are the qualities of the persons, and what are the qualities and glories of Shri Avatar. Please tell us. That means, please describe the Yoga Avatar. Now, Karma Yogi, Karma Bhajan Yogeshwari is answering. Ke Kirtan Tirita Dwaparamcha Kali Ityesh Keshavaha Nana Varna Vadhakaru Nana Yuga Vidhi Nai Chiyate. There are four yoga. Satyog, Treta, Dwapara and Kaliyoga. Krit means Satyog. Krit means where the person is Krit-Kritya. They are fulfilled and they think that we have achieved our goal. This normal feeling are in the persons of chanting Malais of Rudraksh and Vipar Danda Kamandalu. And he is having the danda and kamandalu, the stick and a pitcher with him. Manushyastra tada shanta. At that time, the manushya was very calm, nirvaira. They do not have bile, enmity with anyone. Sruhi like this, hansa, suparna. Shri Krishna has very beautiful. Parna means wings. That means he is riding on the Garuda. Who has the Suparna? Suparna. Vaikuntha. His name is, one name is Vaikuntha. That means where the joy is not ever blunt. Kuntha means being blunt, being stopped. Obstacles are there. But in Vaikuntha, there is no kuntha, there is no hindrances in bhakti. So Vaikuntha. Dharma. Shri Bhagavan is named Dharma by which Ishwar and Amal. He is without any disturbance. Ishwar Purusho Vyakta. He is Ishwar, he is Purush, he is Abhyakt, unknown, he is not. Vyakta, Abhyakt means unknown. Abhyakt, Paramatma iti giyate, and he is Paramatma. In this way, the person worships in Satyuga. And now he will say Treta, and mainly he will say Shri Gaurahari. So the pastimes of Gaurahari will be described on that tomorrow. I shall try.